Hi everyone. Today in this video, let us discuss one of the new drug, Varenicline. Varenicline is one of the drug which helps quit smoking in the people who are willing to stop smoking. This Varenicline acts just like nicotine, but still it can reduce the smoking habits. So this drug is indicated in those people who are intentional to quit smoking. So Varenicline is used in those people for cessation of smoking who are really interested and who know the benefits of use of this drug. Along with proper clinical advice and counseling, this drug can be used to reduce the smoking habits in the people. Interestingly, this drug acts as a nicotine, since this drug acts as partial agonist on nicotinic acetylcholine receptors. Normally, nicotine present in the tobacco can act on the nicotinic acetylcholine receptors, which are expressed on dopaminergic neurons. Particularly, alpha-4 beta-2 receptors are present on the dopaminergic neurons, which are responsible for release of dopamine that increases the pleasure during the smoking. But with prolonged smoking, it may result in cardiovascular complications as well as respiratory complications. That's why in those people who are decided to quit smoking, Varenicline can be given, which acts as a partial agonist on these receptors, thereby it can reduce the release of dopamine. So today in this video, we are going to see what are the important precautions of this drug, how it is given, what are the important side effects, and how this drug really acts in controlling smoking habits. All these things we will discuss in this video. First of all, let us see how this drug acts. Within the midbrain, dopaminergic neurons play an important role in the reward system. These are the presynaptic dopaminergic neurons. Now, the postsynaptic dopaminergic neurons are equipped with dopamine receptors. Now, on the presynaptic neurons, nicotinic acetylcholine receptors are expressed, which are responsible for release of dopamine. During the tobacco smoking, nicotine is going to be released. This nicotine can act on the nicotinic acetylcholine receptors expressed on dopaminergic neurons, which activates these inotropic acetylcholine receptors. Since they are inotropic in nature, they can allow the sodium channels, so sodium can enter through these ion channels, which results in the depolarization, thereby produce the release of dopamine. Now, this dopamine can act on the postsynaptic dopaminergic receptors, which results in their activation. In this way, with chronic smoking, nicotine can repeatedly activate these receptors, which increase the release of dopamine, leading to enhanced activation of dopaminergic neurons. This results in the reward system and increase in the pleasure during the smoking that leads to habit formation. Now, Varenicline is one of the partial agonists on these receptors. It can bind to nicotinic acetylcholine receptors of alpha-2 beta-4 type. Since they act as a partial agonist, they can have both agonist as well as antagonistic activities. They will not allow the nicotine to bind to these receptors, so that the nicotinic action is going to be reduced. But at the same time, they cannot act as a full agonist, so they can reduce the release of dopamine, which reduces the dopaminergic transmission. Since the dopaminergic transmission is reduced, the pleasure during the smoking is reduced, which helps in the cessation of smoking in the intended people. Now, let us see the precautions of this drug. One of the important precautions of Varenicline is that this drug can produce some psychotic behavior. Since this drug acts as a partial agonist on nicotinic acetylcholine receptors, it can modulate the dopaminergic transmission, which may lead to fear of the psychotic symptoms. So with use of Varenicline, we can observe hallucinations, either of auditory or visual hallucinations. Delusions, wrong perceptions can be observed. It can also increase the anxiety, panic symptoms in the patients, along with some agitation and irritability. So with use of Varenicline, care should be taken to check development of these symptoms, and the patient should be thoroughly educated about these side effects that may be possible with use of Varenicline. Second important precaution is that when this Varenicline is given along with alcohol, what happens? Since alcohol is a CNS depressant, it may interact with the activities of Varenicline. So this results in the increased alcoholic effects, resulting in the increased drowsiness, sedation, and disorientation in the people. That's why along with varenicline, alcohol should be carefully used as it increases the central side effects of the alcohol. Another important precaution is in the patients with seizures. So in such patients, varenicline should be carefully given as this drug can increase the risk of seizures. Or in the normal people, again, this drug can increase the risk of seizures when it is co-administered with other CNS stimulants. And this seizure induction is particularly observed in the first month of the treatment. So care should be taken within the first month to check any development of seizures in the patients. Similarly, another important precaution is that varenicline can produce a set of symptoms resulting in somnolence, some sleepiness in the patients, dizziness, lightheadedness, which may cause some imbalance in the patient, and confusion, difficulty in concentrating. All these symptoms may impair the daytime activities on the people. And these effects may also result in accidental injury because of decreased concentration or confused state. So when the people are taking varenicline, care should be taken while driving the vehicles or operating with the machinery, because there is a chance of accidental injury due to altered mental state during the treatment. Another precaution with this drug is the development of hypersensitivity. This drug can produce hypersensitive reactions resulting in skin rashes, angioedema resulting in swelling of neck, tongue and pharynx, which may result in difficulty in breathing, dyspnea. All these effects can be produced with varenicline, and sometimes it can also develop fatal skin reactions like Stevens-Johnson syndrome. In such conditions, this drug should be stopped as these hypersensitive reactions are fatal to the patient. Now let us see the side effects of this drug. One of the important side effects of varenicline is the development of nausea. So nausea and vomiting is commonly observed in many of the people during the first week of the treatment. That's why the dose of the drug should be slowly escalated in order to stabilize the patient towards the varenicline. Similarly, this drug can also produce some abdominal pain, constipation, and flatulence can be developed. Even it can produce some indigestion and dyspepsia. These gastrointestinal side effects are again common with varenicline. It can also affect the central nervous system, resulting in insomnia, lack of sleep, and even it can produce somnolence, increased sleepiness in the patients. So sleep disturbances can be observed with use of varenicline. And importantly, this drug can produce some bad dreams or illogical dreams during the treatment. Dry mouth is another common side effect that can be observed with this drug. Apart from these side effects, it can also produce headache, dyspnea, difficulty in breathing, and fatigue, lack of energy can be observed during the treatment. Now let us see the chemical nature of this drug. So this is the structure of varenicline. It is a tetracyclo compound because four rings are fused. So we can write the name as tetracyclo. Now let us give the numbering to this compound. We can start the numbering from the bridgeheads. Let us start from this carbon. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. And finally, whatever the carbon in between the bridges is the 16. So totally it is having the 16 carbons, and at few of the places carbon is replaced with the nitrogen. So we can write the name of this ring system as hexadeca because of 16 carbons. And it is having the double bonds at 2nd position, 4th position, 6th, 8th and 10th positions, which are alternatively arranged. So we can write this as 2, 4, 6, 8, 10 pentaene. That is the name of this ring system. But here 3 carbons are replaced with nitrogen at 5th position, 8th position and 14th position. So we can write this as 5, 8, 14 triazo. Then what is the fusion between the rings? If we see the whatever the ring on the left side of the first bridgehead, totally we can find the 10 carbons. So we can write this as 10. And on the right side, we can observe 3 carbons. So 3. And within the bridge, we can observe only 1 carbon. So 1. So this is a 10.3.1 ring system. But again, we can find other fusions. Here again, we can observe one fusion where no carbon is present. So we can write this as 0. This 0 exists between the 2nd and 11th elements. So we can represent this as 0 to the power of 2 comma 11. Similarly, we can observe another fusion here. This is again 0, and there is no atom between 4th and 9th element. So we can write this as 0 to the power of 4, 9. So this is the complete name of varenicline. So varenicline is a 5-8-14 triazo tetracyclohexadecapentaene. How it is given? This drug is available as a tablet at different strengths, 0.5 mg as well as 1 mg. The use of varenicline should be started before 1 week, stopping of the smoking. During this 1 week, the dose adjustment can be done such that the side effects can be minimized. So initially it is given at a dose of 0.5 mg given once daily. After 3 days of the treatment, the dose can be slightly increased such that it can be given at a dose of 0.5 mg twice daily. So the total daily dose is 1 mg after 3 days. This dose is continued for next 4 days, and after 4 days, the dose is further increased to 1 mg given twice daily. So the total daily dose is 2 mg after 7 days of the treatment. So on the 8th day, the dose is increased to 1 mg twice daily. And the treatment can be continued up to 12 weeks in order to produce any beneficial effect on cessation of smoking. Even after 12 weeks of treatment, if sufficient response is not observed, then the treatment can be continued for further 12 weeks based on the requirement. This drug is successful in those people who are intentional to quit smoking and who know the benefits of this drug and who are thoroughly counseled to stop smoking. In such people, varenicline can help cessation of smoking, which reduce the cardiovascular as well as respiratory complications. So that's all about this drug varenicline, which is a partial nicotinic acetylcholine receptor agonist. Since this drug is a partial agonist, it can have both agonist as well as antagonistic activities. It binds to nicotinic acetylcholine receptors. At the same time, it prevents the binding of nicotine to these receptors. This results in the decreased response of nicotine, which results in the decreased release of dopamine, leading to less reward system and pleasure during the smoking. Psychotic symptoms may be developed with use of varenicline, where care should be taken. And this drug can also increase somnolence, confusion, and difficulty in concentration, which may result in accidental injury. It can also increase the seizure induction in susceptible patients, and development of nausea is one of the important side effects of this drug. So that's all about this drug, varenicline. Hope you have enjoyed this video. If you like this video, please subscribe to our channel, share this video with your friends, post your comments in the comment box. Thank you for watching this video.